GM fam, I hope you're enjoying the bear market as much as I am, but it's not bears I'm here to talk about today. It's a different animal, the noble ape. Did you get started in cryptocurrency programming using Brownie? Okay, boomer. Bad news. Brownie is no longer being actively maintained, so as the EVM continues to evolve, your skills are going to get increasingly obsolete. If you're ambitious, you could actually just take over the open source project and maintain it yourself, or you could migrate to Ape. Ape has a whole team that's working to keep Ape up to date, along with numerous plugins for a bunch of emerging cryptocurrency technologies. They also have a fantastic ApeWorks Academy, which you can see here, with a lot of helpful tutorials, including this article on how to port a project from Brownie to Ape. So if there's a question you have about Ape, you can probably find it in the documentation or with their helpful community. That being said, we're nonetheless doing this crvUSD Ape tutorial to help solve some of the questions that we get frequently in the dev channel. We often see people who are interested in migrating to Ape, but they have a few issues. They can't structure or sometimes even get started. In particular, Curve uses a lot of mainnet fork features. That is to say that Curve doesn't deploy anything to a testnet, so if you want to test Curve contracts, you got to test the live version using a forked mainnet environment. This first installment of this tutorial, we're just going to give you a quick start guide for how you can get started with interacting with live contracts on the blockchain in just a few lines of code. It's simple, it's easy, and you can just bookmark the companion GitHub repository to have a ready-made and easy-to-get environment for running Ape contracts. So let's begin. First things first, we're going to create a virtual environment. We'll call it Ape VENV. Source ape then bin activate to work within this, and within our virtual environment you'll know that there's no ape command, so we will pip install eth ape. When we were installing Brownie, we used pipx to install it globally, which meant we always had access to Brownie, which was certainly convenient. You could, if you'd like, do the same thing for Ape. You'll notice Ape has a bunch of different plugins, so you might find it more convenient to just install Ape with the plugins you need within your project directory. Once this gets Ape installed, we are going to try and use Ape to run this script that we have here. So you'll notice if we try and run Ape script's crvUSD price, it'll take some seconds to think and it should error out. We have to have the right plugins installed for this to work. It's a simple script though. As you can see, we're importing a contract functionality. We're going to look up the crvUSD price oracle. This is a very special contract which is able to sit and identify all the different peg keepers, which we'll talk about in some of the subsequent units, and figure out what exactly the truth price of crvUSD is, and then we're going to print out that price. So simplest possible script, but if you haven't set up your Ape environment, not going to work. All right, let's go ahead and initialize our environment here. We can do this by typing ape init, similar to Brownie init. What this is going to do is it's going to create the basic directory structure. It's going to create an apeconfig.yaml. It's going to create contract scripts, tests, and some of these already exist. From here, if you'd like to get the only pieces left to get things going with Ape is let's open up our ape config file. Ordinarily, this is blank. What we're going to recommend you do is just copy and paste the code from our ape config into yours. Sometimes the error messages it gives are like a little bit difficult to parse, but if you just copy paste this ape config, we know it works perfect. Similar to the Brownie config, everything in the ape config file is just going to make sure that everything within your particular directory is set up and working in a consistent way. So as we look through this ape config, well, here's the various pieces. The name of this project, of course, is Curve QuickStart. From 2 to 5, we're importing the plugins that we're going to need to actually this environment. Alchemy, Foundry is what we're using to replace Ganache here, and Etherscan. Within the Ethereum mainnet, so lines 7 through 11, this is configuring if you're working within the Ethereum environment. We're going to set in line 8, the default fork will be mainnet fork. This means that when we're running commands on the command line, we don't have to pass the mainnet fork as the network option. And then to the mainnet fork, kind of universe, we're going to be saying that the default provider is Foundry, and we're bumping up the transaction acceptance timeout because some of the crvUSD contracts are a bit complex, and it could actually like time out if you don't bump this up. And then we said the default provider is Foundry. We'd like to set an option within Foundry for the upstream provider to be Alchemy. This is saying, who do we use when we fork? And this is the only flag that we're setting here within Foundry. So if you use this ape config file, I can demonstrate that this is going to work. But first, we need to install these plugins. So one way that ape differs from Brownie is the way that it handles plugins. If you simply type ape plugins install and then pass the current directory, aka just a period, it's going to install Alchemy, Foundry, and Etherscan. So now when we go back and we run our ape script, again, not passing a network, it just knows now that we're using mainnet fork. It's starting up an anvil process. It's going to download from Etherscan the source code for the crvUSD price oracle contract, use this to read the current crvUSD oracle price, and it's going to say that currently, as it's probably the case for you, crvUSD is within about a penny of a dollar. Pretty good. If you got any questions, again, check the ApeWorks Academy documentation. Reach out to me. Happy to answer any questions. Or I found that the Discord Ape community is incredibly helpful with these kinds of things, as is the Curve community. Stay safe, friends. We know it's been a protracted bear market, but we're sure that you can use it to bone up on your skills, get well-versed in Ape, and be ready to roll should the bull market ever run.